Joshua centers, and Talbot just calmly comes out and says, I'll take care of that one before it finds Clifford. And you better believe there's some frustration setting in for the visitors.
This thing settled down here. There. A look at the chemistry developing between Johansson and Fiala. Johansson with a couple of these no-look passes to Fiala, allowing him to get to the middle of the ice. That one just rolls over a stick a little bit. A little beaver tap in frustration. You could have that one back, but you mentioned, Anthony, how the Wild haven't been at their best, but they've been able to win these games. And to me, that's a sign of such a good team. You're not playing well, but you're winning. And to go in there in the morning after a win and say, gosh, we just weren't good enough. We've got to find a way to get better. But you got the result you wanted last night. I mean, it's just such a good thing and a good spot mentally for this club to be in.
Sturm played it to the Blues line. Sanford lost it to Bukestad. Bukestad's then run face first into the wall. That draws some attention from the Wild bench, and Sturm drops the gloves with Sanford. The Wild bench took exception. Sanford delivers an extra blow here after Sturm's on the ice, but Bukestad went face first into the wall, and Nico Sturm, the rookie, quickly jumps to his defense.
And right off the bat, Bukestad gives him a tap and says, thank you. Yeah, I was actually looking at the referee's arms. I thought there was going to be a penalty on that. No penalty. Missed the beginning of the fight. But here's the hit as they go into the wall. Bukestad stops.
Number 12,
it's a dangerous look going into that one, but good job on Sturm to run in there against Sanford.
Wait, I don't know. I'm not sure why that's not a call. Bukestad, it's not like Bukestad turned his back. And Sanford threw him with a little velocity face first into the wall.
Yeah, I think you could call a couple of penalties there, too. A hit from behind, you could call a board.